So today we are going to continue reading the book of Revelation, and we're on chapter 16. Holy Spirit, we need you today. I'm going to pray. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for your word, that we have such access to it. We can read it anytime. We don't have to go to a temple and dig through scrolls. Man, we can just study your word anytime we want. For that, I am so very grateful. So we come before you today, and we just ask, Father, that you grant us wisdom concerning your word, and today, the book of Revelation. We know that prophecy, it can be challenging to understand, and the whole book of Revelation is one giant prophecy. We ask for understanding today. Grant us wisdom. Help us to hear what we need to know. In your name, Jesus, amen. Revelation 16, verse 1. And I heard a great voice out of the temple saying to the seven angels, go your ways and pour out the vials of the wrath of God upon the earth. Huh, we didn't get very far before we had commentary. The word vials actually is translated vials in this version, but it can mean a cup as well. So this could be a cup of wrath. 2. And the first went and poured out his vial on the earth, and there fell a noisome and grievous sore on the men, which had the mark of the beast on them, which worshipped his image. 3. And the second angel poured out his vial on the sea, and it became as the blood of a dead man, and every living soul in the sea died. 4. And the third angel poured out his vial on the rivers and the fountains of water, and they became blood. And I heard the angel of the water say, you are the righteous, O Lord, which are and were and shall be, because you have judged thus. For they have shed the blood of saints and prophets, and you have given them blood to drink, for they are worthy. And I heard another out of the altar say, even so, Lord God Almighty, true and righteous are your judgments. So this makes it clear the reason why wrath is finally poured out. You see, elsewhere in the Bible it talks about there being a cup of wrath. This is in the Old Testament. And Israel would be able to sin for a very, very long time. And once that cup of wrath was filled, then God would release them into the hands of the enemy. In this case, it's actually because of the mark of the beast, and you have to take it or worship the beast or be beheaded. And because they kill the saints of God, because they kill Christians, God's people, this is why the cups have finally become full and all these things are being poured out. Eight. And the fourth angel poured out his vial on the sun, and the power was given him to scorch men with fire. And the men were scorched with a great heat and blasphemed the name of God, which has the power over these plagues. And they repented not and did not give him glory. 10. And the fifth angel poured out his vial on the seat of the beast, and his kingdom was full of darkness, and they gnawed their tongues for pain, and blasphemed the God of heaven because of their pains and their sores, and repented not for their deeds. 12. And the sixth angel poured out his vial on the great river Euphrates, and the water thereof was dried up, that the way of the kings of the east might be prepared. 13. And I saw three unclean spirits like frogs come out of the mouth of the dragon and out of the mouth of the beast and out of the mouth of the false prophet. For they are the spirits of devils working miracles which go forth to the kings of the earth and the whole world to gather them to battle of the great day of God Almighty. So this is interesting. When we did the Revelation series, we did it in order. And one of the things we surmised was that when the Antichrist becomes wounded in the head and is miraculously healed, that he would make a bargain with Satan, who would then have the power to possess him. And that's where his power emanates from. And here we have proof. Not only the Antichrist, but also the beast and out of the false prophet. So remember, there are three things going on here. We have the Antichrist, who is called the dragon, I think, here in this verse. Then we also have the mouth of the beast. Remember, the Antichrist creates a beast that's an AI, and it's a metal thing, they say, and he creates something and puts it in the temple and makes everybody worship it. So that's the beast. So that means the AI will be a spirit. That's where the AI comes from. And then out of the mouth of the false prophet. The false prophet also will be possessed by a demon. Remember, he does miracles in the sight of the Antichrist. So let's continue. 15. Behold, I come as a thief. Blessed is he that watches and keeps his garments, lest they walk naked and they see his shame. And he gathered them together in a place called in the Hebrew tongue Armageddon. 17. And the seventh angel poured out his vial into the air, and there came a great voice out of the temple of heaven and from the throne, saying, It is done. And there were voices and thunders and lightnings, and there was a great earthquake, such as not has since men were on the earth, so mighty an earthquake and so great. And the great city was divided into three parts, and the city of the nations fell, and the great Babylon came into remembrance before God to give her the cup of wine of the fierceness of his wrath. 20. And every island fled away, and the mountains were not found. 21. And there fell on man a great hail out of heaven, and every stone about the weight of a talent. And men blasphemed God because of the plague and of hail, for the plague thereof was exceedingly great. Okay, so this is the wrath of God. This is what will come after the tribulation. So remember, the very first class in Revelation, the Revelation series, the Lord had us develop a tribulation timeline. Most people think that the seven-year agreement is the end of the world, and that's when this Armageddon happens, but not according to what the Lord showed us. That there's actually 19 years left. The 7 years begins the beginning of the 19 years, and any time in the last 7 years, that's years 12 through 19, the Lord can return. And so, but it can't be, he can't begin to return until year 12. So go look at the tribulation timeline and know that this is the wrath of God. It's poured out after Daniel's week, after a 7 year period. And it's not going to be a fun time at all. I can't imagine every mountain being removed, every island disappearing, that is a great calamity. It says all the cities of the world fell. And a while back, someone had a dream. They sent it to me, and it confirmed what the Lord had been telling me. He had been showing me visions of the night of what would happen right before his return, what the state of the world would be in. And I didn't want to think about it. And then I wasn't even sure what he was showing me was accurate. I'm like, oh, maybe it's just a vain imagination. And then somebody sent me this. It was a vision of what the world would be like when the Lord returned. At the Lord's return, when he began to rule and reign. And every city in the world was nothing but a big heap of rubble. Everything fell. And that will be the beginning of the Lord's reign, but it won't happen until that occurs. So I don't know about you, but I definitely don't want to be here for this. I want to be gone for this part. Let's continue. This is Revelation 17. Revelation 17, verse 1. And there came one of the seven angels, which had the seven vials, and talked with me, saying, Come here, I will show you the judgment of the great whore that sits on many waters. Now this is great proof that these things flow in a line, that the book of Revelation is actually very orderly, because it's now one of the angels who carried the vials. So this is after the vials. Now he's showing them something that has happened. 2. With whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth have been made drunk with the wine of her fornication. 3. So he carried me away in the spirit in the wilderness, and I saw a woman sit on a scarlet-colored beast, full of the names of blasphemy, having seven heads and 10 horns. Four. And the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup in her hand, full of the abominations of and filthiness of her fornications. 5. And on her head was a name written, Mystery, Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth. 6. And I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus. When I saw her, I wondered with great admiration. This is really, really, really metaphorical. But the cool thing is, it's the same beast that we saw rising, and who the Antichrist is one of the heads. So we see it has seven heads and 10 horns. And one of those heads is the Antichrist, and one, I think, is a false prophet. So now it's going to be explained what that beast is. We should always use the book of Revelation to interpret Revelation whenever possible. And it's just a matter of reading it until you find the definition. So let's continue. 7. And the angel said to me, Why do you marvel? I will tell you the mystery of the woman and the beast that carries her, which has the seven heads and 10 horns. 8. The beast that you saw was and is not, and shall ascend out of the bottomless pit and go into perdition. And they that dwell on earth shall wonder, whose names are not written in the book of life from the foundations of the world. And they behold the beast that was and is not, and yet is. 9. And here is the mind which has wisdom. The seven heads are seven mountains on which the woman sits. And there are seven kings. 5 are fallen, 1 is, and the other is not yet to come. When he comes, he must continue for a short space. 11. And the beast was and is not, and even he is the 8th, and there is of the 7th that goes into perdition. 12. And the 10 horns which you saw are 10 kings, which have received no kingdom as yet, but receive power as kings for 1 hour with the beast. 13. And they have one mind, and shall give all the power and the strength to the beast. So the beast is referred to as is, was not, and is. And yet is. Let's see, where is that? That was and is not and shall ascend, and was and is not and yet is. These descriptions show something of a spiritual nature. It was, that means it has always been, it's Satan's army. But yet it is, because even though it's not in the physical world, it is a spiritual thing. And so it is not a physical reality, and yet it is. So, and it has all the power that's the power of Satan, the beast, all his minions, and the head that rules it, the Antichrist, is going to have all the power of Satan behind him. And then there are 10 kings which have not received a kingdom yet. So these aren't literal kings, it's people who are given the power of kings, and they are given them for a small space. So let's continue. 14. And these shall make war with the Lamb, and the Lamb shall overcome them, for he is the Lord of lords and King of kings, and they that are with him are called and chosen and faithful. 15. And he said to me, The waters which you saw were where the whore sits, are peoples and multitudes and nations and tongues. 16. And the 10 horns which you saw on the beast, these shall hate the whore. And they shall make her desolate and naked, and shall eat her flesh and burn her with fire. For God has put it in their hearts to fulfill his will and to agree. And they gave their kingdom to the beast until the words of God shall be fulfilled. And the woman which you saw is that great city which reigns over the kings of the earth. Like many things in Revelation, that is one verse which we might not know for a long time how that applies. What is the city that is the woman that sits on the beast, that has all this power and has the ability to kill the saints, you know, to martyr them, who is likened to Jezebel? We don't know. There could be several things. It could be Tokyo, which is a big, powerful city. It could be Rome. It could be where, because that's a seat of power for the Catholic Church. It could also be New York. We don't know at this time. We did research this quite a bit and come up with some more information in the series. But as you can see, the Book of Revelation is a puzzle. Sometimes we don't know what each piece is, but we know how they fit together. Until I see you again, may God bless and keep you all. Shalom.